So today we've got with us a new brand that's getting into the country, MG. And this is the MG Hector. I know the name sounds a little funny, but this car, or rather I should say this SUV, is going to be competing with the Mahindra XUV500, the Tata Harrier, the Jeep Compass, and probably even the Hyundai Creta. Now, MG has loaded this vehicle with a lot of features. The vehicle I'm driving here is the petrol-hybrid. It has a 48-volt system, which means it recharges the battery when you brake or decelerate. And it puts out, it's a 1.5-liter turbo petrol that puts out 143 PS of power and 250 newton meters of torque. Now, I mean, these are numbers being thrown at you. The point is, how does it drive? That's what I'm going to show you in this video with the petrol MG Hector, and a little later with the diesel. Straight off, here are three things I really like about the Hector. It feels solidly built. The doors are heavy and shut reassuringly. Secondly, the ride quality. It has a good suspension setup that absorbs all the bumps easily. And then there is the long feature list. What I don't like about the Hector, it has too much bling about it, like the various colors and textures. Then there's the engine sound in the diesel that intrudes a bit, while the petrol is quiet enough. And a few other things like the overall proportions of the vehicle. MG is playing the features card to get the Hector out of its showroom, from the large panoramic sunroof to color selectable ambient lighting. It has it all. A 360 degree reverse camera, hill start assist, push button ignition, and cruise control are all there. The selling point, it is internet enabled, meaning it has an embedded SIM powered by Airtel. You even have an app that can remotely control functions of the car. You can remotely open the boot or set a perimeter alarm and stuff like that. It's similar to what Hyundai has in the Venue. Now the 10.4-inch touchscreen infotainment system in the MG Hector is activated by voice commands, which means you have an assistant called, well, MG. Hello, MG.
I'm here.
Turn on the radio. Okay, let's see if it tries accents. Hello, MG.
Hi, how can I help?
Set the temperature to 20 degrees.
Temperature is set to 20 degrees Celsius.
So this thing has machine learning, so it takes a bit of time to understand accents. And then you can also do things like, hello MG, open the sunroof. And there you go. Makes you even lazier than you were. The MG Hector 1.5 turbo petrol comes with a 6-speed manual transmission. The gear throws are fairly decent, not too long, not too short, and it slots in neatly, clutch is light. The handling, now that's something a lot of you have asked me about. It is fairly neutral, I would say. Being an SUV, yes, there's some body roll, but it is quite sorted. How does it compare to the Harrier? I would say probably at par with the Harrier, and probably better than the XUV500. Ride quality in the MG Hector is surprisingly good. For you enthusiasts out there, is this a sporty car? I wouldn't really call it sporty. Does the job, but probably not as sure-footed as the Jeep Compass. I'm now driving the diesel variant of the MG Hector. And this comes with a 2-liter diesel engine that's pretty familiar. Why? Because it's the same engine that goes into the Jeep Compass and the Tata Harrier. This puts out 170 PS of power and 350 Newton meters of torque. So the feel of the engine is pretty much like what you get in the Jeep Compass, including the feel of the gearbox. It's got a lot of torque, pulls really well from low RPM. But yes, you do hear some of the engine noise inside the cabin. Still, that's not much of a bother. Now, the MG is all about interior space. It has the longest wheelbase in its segment, 2750 mm to be precise, which means someone of my height, which is 5'8", gets plenty of space at the rear The rear seat also reclines to different angles. You can put it right back like this or fairly upright, which is a typical SUV stance. And you get a completely flat floor over here, which means sitting three abreast isn't much of a problem, except that the Hector is slightly narrow. So yeah, three skinny adults, not very fat ones. The Hector, being a five-seater, comes with a rather spacious 587-litre boot. Enough for your weekend luggage, except that it has a pretty high floor here, so you have to lift your suitcases and shove them in. It also has some underfloor storage over here with something that looks like space for a rather tiny spare wheel. The actual spare wheel, though, is under the car. So after driving both the petrol and the diesel versions of the MG Hector, one thing I can say is that this segment, the competition is just going to heat up, because this vehicle is really capable. It gives you space, it's got a lot of features. Sure, there are some shortcomings, but then so does every other vehicle in the segment have its good points and its bad points. Which of the two would I pick between the petrol and the diesel? Well, I like the torque of the diesel, but the petrol too is surprisingly good. If you like this video, please don't forget to share and subscribe to the Quint.